What made you want to be an author?
I've always been a book person. First of all, I think, so I was an avid reader, a young reader, loved books, always, I think most avid readers, I think, have story ideas and they think they want to be writers. And I do think pretty much all avid readers are writing something somewhere. You come to a point where you're going like, I could do that better, I could do that differently.
You talk about always wanting to write. Was there any time in your childhood that you wanted to be something besides a
writer? I thought I was going to be a lawyer, but not so much. Yeah, and I don't know if that was just something that my dad told me I should probably be, you know, when
you
I grew up.
You said you were adopted. What was one of the struggles that thought about?
It's feeling accepted. You know, there were times in my life where I got bullied because, you know, well, you don't have your real parents, or your parents and mother didn't love you, and that just, you know, mean kid stuff.
You've had a lot of changes and challenges in your life that you've talked about in your PowerPoint. How did you get through them? What do you suggest to others?
You can either let bad experiences take you all the way down, or you can choose to become stronger from them. And you know, it's easy to say it now with perspective, and it's harder when you're going through those things to realize that it actually does get better. That, you know, if you've lost somebody now, there's somebody in the future that will come to you. Love, you know, we're looking to love and be loved. That's the main thing in all our lives. And so when you lose love or love goes wrong, that's the stuff that usually really takes you down. But there is love out there all around us. I feel like, look, the universe is full of love. We have to figure out ways to accept it, to find good kinds of love.
So if you wanted to tell the students that go to Aiken's one thing, what would you tell them?
Just to remember that, like, this is your life up to this point, and there's this much more to come. So you need to always be looking forward and into the future. The choices you make now will affect who you are today.